period, so I'm using the African black soap, the real one. Your soap should be brown, not black. And I got this from Amazon. So I'm going to use the 60-second rule, and I'm going to take my soap and wet my fingers and rub that into my face for 60 seconds. And actually, in this video, I'm going to take it a step further, and I'm going to wash my face for 3 minutes. Because typically, people only wash your face or cleanse your face for about 20 seconds, maybe 15. And that's not enough for your soap or your cleanser to do anything. So when you do it for 60 seconds or even 3 minutes, it really gets into your pores. It gets all that oil, the dirt, the bacteria, and using your fingertips increases the circulation. And I'm gonna keep doing that. You're gonna see me get a little annoyed in a second. Alright, so now I'm just going to rinse that off with my white washcloth. If you do choose to use a washcloth, you should not be using the same cloth that you use on your butt, on your face. You need a different one. So I use white anytime I wash my face. Alright, now I'm going to use some apple cider vinegar for my toner and these sponge pads that I got from Walmart, and they have these little bumps on it, and I'm going to use the side with the bumps because it gets the rest of the dirt and all the oil that I didn't catch from cleansing my face. And if you don't want to use apple cider vinegar, you could always use witch hazel. Alright, next I'm going to use my Shea Sugar Scrub, and I'm going to apply that all over my face and to my lips. Alright, so now I'm going to take one of those sponges and wipe all of this stuff off my face. And as you can see, that stuff was nasty. It got on the inside of my mouth, and I used my rag to just wipe it out. But those sponges really help getting the sugar scrubs off my face. And when I do my biotin clay mask, it really helps. Thank you. All right, so now I'm gonna tone again. And I was a little hesitant because usually after I do a sugar scrub, my face is a little sensitive, so it stings sometimes. And yeah, and you have to be careful with these pads because they leave little cottons behind on your face. But as far as using a toner, after any step, you should tone. When you cleanse, you tone. You do an exfoliating mask or whatever, you tone. You do another type of mask, you tone. And then you go in with your serum or whatever you use. So now I'm going to use some olive oil and some tea tree oil. And all you need is one drop. And I'm going to mix that together and apply that to my face using the palm of my hand. You use the palm of your hand to apply, your fingertips to rub it in. Alright, so right now my face looks really good, and you can stop here, but I'm going to take it a step further and I'm going to use African shea butter, just like a dime sized amount, and I'm going to apply that the same way that I did the oil, and this is what gives me that glowy look. Alright, the last thing I'm going to do is use my EOS and my lip gloss. This is how I apply my lip gloss every time. I never just put on the lip gloss straight because some of them dry out my lips. And I put on the EOS or any type of chapstick and then just a little drop of lip gloss and it lasts. It goes a long way. People think that I put a whole lot on, but I really don't. Alright, so now my lips popping, face is glowing, face feeling fresh, looking good.